Salutations, everyone. My name is Kinesis, and welcome to a new playthrough we're all going to, well, I'm going to be doing Fallout Tales of Two Wastelands. Now, here's the thing. The game might look kind of pixelated because it's the only way we can record this without it having a bunch of glitches on. This is the only way we can record this without this having a bunch of glitches. Because the one problem that Phantom had whenever he would record something like Fallout on the channel is that it would be very glitchy, not glitchy, very laggy whenever he talked to anyone. So whenever Phantom talked to someone, it would lag so much. So he found a way, since he did Minecraft, he found a way to lower the lag. And that was to do all this different stuff, I guess. So here's the thing. Here's what we're gonna do. Minecraft is not stopping. Phantom is still going to be doing Minecraft on the channel, but this is going to be the main playthrough for now. Guess. This is going to be the main playthrough for now. Because right now, Phantom is going through a little problem with Minecraft because it's getting very, like, laggy. Like, not in the video, but in the actual game. Because, again, we do not have the best computer. Heck, I'm playing on medium quality. So, stuff will not appear that close. I'm not gonna do hardcore mode. Maybe later in the playthrough I'll start to do hardcore. But not right now. Anyway, so this is Tales of Two Wastelands. Basically, we are playing Fallout New Vegas in the world of Fallout 3. So we have everything. We got the map, we got the quests, we got the radio, we got everything. And this is my character right here. This is my character. And in case you guys want to see my stats, this is my special, this is my skills. These are my perks for right now. Four Eyes, Swift Learner, and Trigger Discipline. And yeah. So this is what we're working with right now. So our first goal is actually to go over there to Megaton, but what I usually like to do, these are gonna pop up a lot. What I usually really like to do, I get it. Is actually head over here and loot this place around here. Now, later in the playthrough, I will actually start to use mods or something.
John Henry Keaton, President of the Enclave. President of your heart.
Alright. Alright, cool. Yeah, I'm probably gonna be doing that a lot because I do not like the Enclave. I hate the Enclave. Only because of what they do later in the game. Now, I have not actually just I'm not hand over to Megaton first because there's actually a way to get a player house. I have not decided if I'm gonna be doing both New Vegas and 3 in one go. I will definitely try to be doing as much as Fallout 3, at least as much as the Capital Wasteland as I can. Okay.
Welcome.
I've never seen. I've never seen a raider appear over here. Alright, well.
Head on in,
I hope actually this is working correctly. Because there is a little glitch that can happen.
I'll be dead.
Yep.
Another newcomer.
Hold on. Yeah.
Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, girl. Something tells me you're all right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something.
Oh, nice time you got here, Sheriff. It's a pleasure to meet you.
Friendly and well-mannered. I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like.
Right, message received.
I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with?
Now, we could ask, the main... Actually, quick thing. People are gonna probably ask, why'd you skip the beginning of the game? Blah, blah, blah. Well, actually, I had to skip the beginning of the game because Tales of Wisdom has a little problem, well, at least for me, that I can't go to the beginning of the game, like, going through... I can't go through, the part of the game where you actually go through the door before your birthday, or whatever, like when you're a baby, or something. It's hard to explain. I can't go through that door and not have the game crash. So, I have a little save right here. Right here. Where it just puts me right in front of the door. And it puts me right in front of the door so that I can actually go out into the world of the Capital Wasteland. So, yeah, that's the sad part. We're not going to be seeing the beginning of the game.
I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? You think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good?
Let's see if I can summon that bomb for you.
Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you. Not an option, I'm afraid. We aren't exactly rolling in cash down here.
I thought it would work. Fine.
Great. Go ahead and see what you can do. Just be careful.
Let's go ahead and go and disarm the bomb. Now, the reason why I'm disarming this bomb right now,
hey.
I actually put a little tag into explosives right here so that I am able to disarm this bomb. I do this every time I play through. Every time I play through Fallout 3 or whatever. So I always put a tag in explosive so that I can disarm this bomb the second I come into the town so that I can get a player house, which is right there. And player houses are very useful.
I'll be damned. You did it, didn't you? You disarmed that thing. Here's your reward. Hell, why don't you move in? Could use someone like you. Got an empty place here you can use. Here's the key indeed. It ain't much to look at, but talk with Moira. She's got random odds and ends you might be able to spruce the place up with.
Alright, actually, 1 second. Hold on. Whoops, one thing. Oh! I forgot to turn on this! That little, kinesis thing down there might be annoying for some of you, but I like to have it there. I don't know what repair it is. I'm gonna put repair up to 30. Because there's another thing I want to get done. There's another thing I want to get done in this town. But I don't know what level my repair needs to be at. Emma, this is the Megaton house right here. Here's one thing that we are going to definitely be doing. Before we even touch New Vegas, like the Mojave Wasteland, I am going to get all of the bobbleheads. I am definitely going to get all the bobbleheads. So, the special bobbleheads and then the regular ones. And there's actually one that's in this town. Actually, I think we actually have one right now. Yeah, the medicine bobblehead. I'm just gonna put that right there. So yeah, the medicine bobblehead. There, I think I may be wrong, but I think there is actually a way to have all of your special stats be 10 and all of your regular stats be 100 if you play correctly. Now, what I'm going to do is actually, I'm going to put my book somewhere else. Let's go in here. Red roach meat in there. I'll keep the purified waters. Down there. Okay. I'm going to put everything that I am not using currently in here. Like mixed stuff. That. I might as well sell this because this has no use. I'll store this stuff in there for now. And then I'll sell it all in one go. Just to see how much I get. Alright. What I really like to do is I like to come up here. Okay, if I go to sleep. I like to make this my weapon stash. And I like to make the desk right here my clothing stash, I guess. I don't know. Oh, whoops. There we go. Actually, I think I might sell the armor I have on me. Except for the town snake outfit. I'm gonna definitely put that in here. Should I keep this? Nah. I'm probably not gonna keep it, to be honest. Because I'm not gonna keep the lightweight armor, only because there's so much more better armors out there. Like, I think my own file, I have a reinforced combat armor, and it's so much better. It's almost like wearing power armor or something. I'm not even gonna I might hold back story spoilers about this game, but item spoilers or whatever, I'm not holding back because I'm sure at this point most people has at least played Fallout at least once.
I hear you're that stray from the vault. I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say,
no!
I'm working on a book about the wasteland.
Oh, no!
It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you?
I just spilled iced tea everywhere. No! My 3DS is soaked! Oh, crap! Oh, I have towels right here. Oh, but they're soaked! No! This sucks! No! To clean that later. The freaking Switch grip thingies are, well, not the Joy-Cons, but like little slide things you put them on that you usually play Mario Odyssey with. Those are covered. Some of my 3DS games are covered. God. I'll have to clean it up later after the episode.
Great! Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life, or to come outside for the first time, or whatever strikes your fancy.
Note to self, never record and drink at the same time. I don't know if any of these other options get you the suit back here, but I always picked this and I was in the green suit.
Yeah, you wouldn't imagine how hard it is to replace that big light bulb up there too. That's great for a foreword. Open with a joke and all that. Here, take the suit. Something tells me you might need it. That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun.
What's this book you're working on?
Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean, mean words.
Sounds like a great idea. I can't wait to help.
Good enthusiasm.
I see everywhere.
Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first?
Getting food is expensive. What are you looking for?
Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right?
Sorry, everyone
knows
it's a little stuffy.
So they need a place to find them. There's an old super duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it.
Okay, I'll check the super duper mart.
Oh, great! Food is most important. But see if you can get medicine, too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay?
I'm actually going to sell some stuff to her. She actually has a nice amount of money on her at first. I might actually keep this, to be honest, just to do science plus 5 stuff. But it's only one cap, so I guess I can come back. I guess I can come back and buy it off of her later. Um, can get off of her. Is it worth it? I don't think it is. What weapons do you have? You have an assault rifle already? You know what? Why not? Screw it. Let's do it. I don't have any ammo for it at
all.
Good
hunting.
And it's also a bad condition, but whatever. Alright, so, yeah, instead of doing the main quest, which is following your footsteps, let's instead do the Wasteland Survival Guide. Actually, there's someone I want to find. There is a bobblehead in this house, which is actually Lucas Sims' house. But I'm not going to grab that until I have a certain perk. If that perk is even still in this game. I'm just going to skip off this. Basically, he's just going to say that there's some pipes that have some leaks in them. And he's asking me to go find them and fix them. I think I remember where all of them are. One's right here. Yes! So I have just enough. There, one's there and one should be up here.
Come, drink
with me. So I have just enough repair to do this. Over there? Yes, it is. Okay. And I will not lie, this game might crash a few times. Fix the pipe, thank you.
Until the day of division. Until the dawn of your return.
I might also install some other mods like
Evening.
Project Nevada. I almost said Project Adventure. that is actually a class in a gym class in Phantom Mind School. Yes, that's a real thing that Phantom and me do. Well, technically only I do it. Cause
what do you need?
Phantom is not that. I don't know. It mostly involves climbing, and he's not that big into climbing. Even though I don't really. I have like these weird paddle arm hand thingies. But whatever.
Well, I'll be. The pressure's up in the plant. It looks like all the leaks have been fixed. Thank you, stranger. Thank you. But listen, it's only a matter of time before they burst again. And someone like you might not be around to fix them. I'll make you a deal. I'll give you caps for any scrap metal you can bring me. You'll find it all over the place out there in the waste. If I have a steady supply of scrap, I can keep the plant running and the pipe should be just fine. We got a deal? Good. This just keeps looking better. Those parts will keep this place running and the town in fresh water. Hurry back as soon as you find some.
Now, Walter here will give you 10 caps per scrap metal you give him. So I'm gonna grab as much scrap metal as I possibly can out in the wastes. Now let's just go ahead and fast travel over to Springvale, because there's another place I want to go ahead and head over to. After this video, I have to like go grab a towel or something. I have to put my freaking computer on that crate thing next to me anyways. because I actually do not have a alarm to wake me up for school. So I have to use my computer as my alarm. So actually, should we use a gun? Because there's actually someone in this house that I am actually going to attack.
Careful with assault, assault.
Alright. I only did that because of the amount of caps she has. How much damage does this do? 10? Is it worth it? Nah, I'm not gonna take it. I'm just gonna take your stuff now. I'm not gonna take dirty water, by the way, because I see no use in it, to be honest. But purified water is so much better. Now, he will only take scrap metal. He will not take scrap electronics. I tried that before. It did not work. There's actually a place I want to go to. Where right from Vault Tech? Dear Mr. and Mrs. Gomez, congratulations on your family's recent inclusion in the Vault 101 community. You will find outlined in your application materials a full review of rules and producers related to preparing for shelter in a Vault Tech facility. But we will outline a few key points here. Okay, if you guys don't know, Mr. and Mrs. Gomez are actually two Vault Dwellers that were in the Vault 101 that you could have met. But I didn't get to meet them because of the little glitch that happens in this game. And apparently the person that made this file did not, had already picklocked something. You probably picked a lock on the overseer's room. Oh my god. I'm sorry for being a little bit sick in this episode. I wasn't like this before, I swear. Hold on. Wrong button, but whatever. Alright, well, this is Springvale School. And as you can see, there's a bunch of raiders in this place.
Come on, come on!
And I leveled up again.
This is bullshit. Come out and fight!
Where are you, dude? Come on, I know you're here.
I'm gonna teach you a
how. I'm probably mostly going to be taking all the ammo these guys have. Ooh, a combat knife. I'm definitely gonna be taking that. I guess to go. Simpex. Anything else of use? This right away. I guess beer could be useful, but I'm not gonna take it. I would take it if this is like something like dust or something. Oh my god, that guy's neck. I would take the beer if this is like dust or something, which is actually a survival simulator. But how much is it doing? 7. So Dust is a survival simulator that basically makes the game a whole lot harder. Maybe one day I'll actually do a playthrough of Dust.
Come on.
If I'm even able to do anything in Dust. Let's get our melee weapons up by a bunch. I like to make these stats nice and even with 25s and like other stuff, whatever. I think explosives can go up a bit. Yep, there we go, education. Now, the one thing I do all the time in this game is that I like to look in every tiny spot possible in everywhere I explore. Everywhere I go, I look in every spot for stuff I can use. Like, I always look around desks, I look around even in like the tiniest spot, I'm actually about to die. That. That should be enough. Mining log. Hit a goddamned hive of ants in the tunnel. Okay, I'm not gonna say that. Ate 7 of our best diggers before we could lock off the way in. Need to find some way to poison them so we can keep digging and blast into that bomb. If you don't get there soon, I think I'm going to end up like Boppo, except it won't be the sheriff popping me. It's gonna be my own men. Okay. I think I'm actually gonna end this off here now. So next time, wow. Okay, these voice cracks. So, next time on Fallout Tales of Two Wastelands, we will be continuing on. Alright, so next time on Fallout Tales of Two Wastelands, we will be continuing on through the Springvale Elementary School, I think, just Springvale School, or I guess I might. We'll be continuing exploring this place, and then maybe after the school, we'll be going over to the Super Duper Mart. See you guys then. Goodbye.